Eric Bakker, thanks for coming back. Let's talk about genes, not the genes you wear, but the genes as in genetics, okay? Do skinny genes really exist or is it a myth? Well, I think they do exist, and I think scientists know that too, and they work that out. And there are many studies conducted over the years to look at some type of genetic link to weight. And of course, for profit, because the scientists then want to work out how they can manipulate these genes with different drugs, especially for, you know, diabetic use or, you know, for people that are very obese. So if we go back more than 50 years ago, there was a scientist, actually, I think this person now is a professor emeritus at Arizona State University. He was working with fruit flies, the Drosophila. Many people, scientists work with fruit flies because they're a great way to study genetics. And what this doctor found was that some fruit flies were fatter and some fruit flies were small and some were quite skinny and lean. And they discovered that there was a big advantage for the fat fruit flies because they could carry more fat in times of hardship, which would carry them through. So when we look at insects or some animals like polar bears, for example, that need to carry a lot of fat to survive the hard times. But however, this is not really what we want in New York City or in LA, is it? We don't want to carry around like a big fat butt like, you know, some people do, movie stars that I won't name, because they have to survive some type of nuclear winter or something. Not really. People today like those kind of butts for Instagram. Well, you don't see fruit flies with iPhones flying around, do you? Okay, it's more of a survival thing. So genes do work in some sense for prolonging or surviving a species, but for humans, clearly not. So genetics came into it, and the gene that was found, the doctor called adipose was the name of this gene that was found. So adipose has been studied now for some time, and they did mice and rat studies with this particular gene called adipose, and they found quite remarkable things that if they increase the adipose activity, for example, that a mice could live longer and burn fat faster than one who didn't have that activity, you know, kicked up. Also, it's interesting, other study was conducted over, I think, almost close to 100,000 people, where they found about 1 in 2,000 had a variation on chromosome 16. So there's a small extra patch of information on this chromosome that in most people wasn't present. And this extra patch on that part of the genetic code of the person ensured that the person's appetite was a little bit more sort of depressed than average person. But particularly those people could be very considered very lean or skinny or even underweight in some sense, a dangerous sense. You probably know a lady or a guy that can eat whatever they want and they just don't put on weight. Okay, now that could be part of this chromosomal, you know, aberration that we're talking about here. In fact, it's quite dangerous for some people. I've got some patients that no matter what they eat, they just can't gain any weight at all. It's not nice, okay? It's just as awful being in that situation as it is being, you know, 300 or 400 pounds. So you'd be surprised how many patients over the years have seen me who want to gain weight rather than lose weight, all right? So genetics can play a role in it. But in my opinion, genetics also predetermine the personality. You know, the type of person that we're dealing with. And that personality will also naturally drive up or down the endocrine system. So their hypothalamic control, their pituitary control, their thyroid control could be, you know, the little adjusting screw could be turned in a little bit too much for some people or a little bit backed out for others genetically. And that can also affect the person's weight. Okay? Remember, it's not just about eating. It's also about moving and about lifestyle that will determine your weight. But genetics play a big role. You only have to look at families to see what a person will possibly look like as they get older. And that's called genetics. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to click on the link below if you want my free Candida paper. Thank you.